Online forms are excellent tools for a variety of different purposes. You can capture leads, collect useful data, understand your audience better, and even find out what type of fruit you are. They really are brilliant. No matter when or where, you have most likely encountered an online form before at some point in your life. And most likely, you have encountered a form in the form of a Google form. And that's not surprising. Google Forms is one of the most popular online form builder platforms that is easy to use, reliable, and you can't forget the most important aspect, it's free to use. But like with all free services, it is limited in design, and things get challenging when you try and embed your Google Form onto your website or any other platform. What's up, guys? My name is Bobby, and in today's video, I will show you a step-by-step tutorial on how you can embed your Google Form onto your WordPress website. But I will also highlight the tool's limitations and how you can overcome them by using other off-the-shelf tools. I've timestamped everything in the description below, so if you want to jump to a specific part of the video, you can easily do that. Let's get right into it. Google Forms is an online platform where you can create and share forms and surveys. It is part of Google Suite, which also hosts Google Docs, Google Sheets, Google Drive, and several other platforms, which makes it easy to integrate with other apps. Google Forms has a lot of benefits. It is free to use and it is also very user-friendly. It is easy to create and design simple forms, and it is also easy to share because it is a part of Google Suite. If you are looking for a free and easy to use platform to create forms, then Google Forms is for you. However, keep in mind, as with most free services, it is going to be limited in customization and design options, as well as embedding options. So while Google Forms is a good platform to use, it is not the best out there. So let me show you how you can create a Google Form. To get started, just click on the plus button at the top left corner of your screen. Then you can edit the title and the description of your form. As you can see, it already added the first question into our form, so you can go ahead and edit that. Google Forms has this great feature where it recognizes the type of question you are trying to ask, and it changes the response type accordingly. There's some real-life Google-based AI in action for you. However, if you don't like the type of question it changed it to, you can always click on the response type, and a drop-down menu will appear where you can choose from several different response types, such as short answer, paragraph, multiple choice, checkboxes, and drop-down menu. But for this question, Google Forms selected the right one for me, so I will leave it as a short answer. I will also turn the required toggle on so my users have to answer each question in my form. Then to add another question, simply click on the plus button on the right side of your first question, and it will add another question below the first one. So once I've finished writing my questions, I will also change the design of my Google Form a bit. So I'm going to go to the top right of my screen where it says customize theme. This looks like a little paintbrush palette. And I will choose an image under header. And it already has several graphics included on the platform. So I will just select this coffee one. And it automatically changes the theme colors for me. However, if I don't like the theme colors, I can always just choose custom colors and just have it in a plain blue color, for example. And lastly, I can also change the font style. So they have four font styles here: basic, decorative, formal, and playful, but I will leave it as basic. Unfortunately, besides these options, you can't really personalize your form on Google Forms. So to embed a Google Form, just go to the top right corner of your screen where it says send and click on it. And a pop-up window will appear. Here, you have three different options. The first option is to send your form through email. So on this screen, you simply enter the email addresses that you want to send your form to, and Google Forms will do that for you. The second option is to simply copy and paste the URL provided by Google Forms onto any other platform where you would like to share your form to. And the third option, which is the one we are looking for, is the iframes embed code. It is the icon that looks like two pointy arrows. Here you are provided with an iframes code that you can copy and paste into your website. So simply copy this code onto your clipboard and then head on over to your WordPress website. To embed this onto a page on my WordPress, I will simply go to the page that I would like to embed this form into, and then I will click on the plus button that appears on the middle of the page. Here, a pop-up window will appear and you will have to select custom HTML. Then it will add a little text box onto your page, and here you will need to paste the embed code that you have copied earlier from Google Forms. So once you have copied it, you can click on preview and it will show you how it looks like on your WordPress page. If you want to embed your Google Form on your WordPress blog post, the process is exactly the same. As you can see, it's quite easy and simple to do this. However, there are quite a few limitations when it comes to Google Forms. Google Forms doesn't allow you a lot of design options and is very generic and basic. It doesn't stand out and capture your audience's attention. Additionally, it doesn't allow you to change the size of the iframes. This might create a very unpleasant user experience. The contents of your form might be cut off, and your users would have to awkwardly scroll in the small tab that they are allowed to view your form in. This doesn't look very visually appealing, and it's also quite challenging for your users to complete your survey. Furthermore, Google Forms lacks in responsiveness and will look different in different browsers. A Google Form that looks spectacular in Google Chrome might look like a messy blob when you're using something like Safari. This also means that Google Forms isn't the most mobile friendly. The bad news is that Google Forms only allows you to create a very limited and generic form, which is not very visually appealing or attention grabbing, which is not at all what you want when you're trying to capture leads. The good news is there are professional form builders like Involve Me, where you can create unique, personalized and responsive forms that are flexible in design and functionality. And the most incredible feature of Involve Me is that you are able to mimic a conversation with your customers to a much greater extent than Google Forms can. You must be wondering, how? While Google Forms only allows you to list your questions, Involve Me is able to guide your users through a set of questions by adding multiple pages onto your form. This creates more of a conversation with your audience rather than a long list of questions. Involve Me has several features which makes it a better alternative to Google Forms. Firstly, it generates a higher conversion rate. The one question per page approach gets 63% conversion rate. That means that 63% of people that click your form will complete it. By using Involve Me, you get more leads from the same amount of traffic. Secondly, you get more personalization. The one question per page approach allows you to decide what happens after a specific answer has been selected. Different follow-up questions can be asked or skipped thanks to logic jumps, or an entirely different part of your website can load thanks to custom redirects. Overall, Involve Me can create a more personalized and branded conversation with your audience. Thirdly, Involve Me is more responsive. This means that no matter what browser you use, your form is always going to look fantastic. And it is also mobile friendly. Fourthly, Involve Me allows you to have branded forms. With our personalization and customization tools, you are able to always stay on brand with your website. Lastly, Involve Me allows greater flexibility when it comes to embedding your form onto your website. So let me show you how using Involve Me rather than Google Forms may just be the right decision for you. To start off, Involve Me has over 200 templates that you can use for whatever purpose you need it for. Today, for this tutorial, I will be using the Hello Yellow signup form, which you can find under the Forms category. So just hover over the template that you like and click on Choose. Involve Me has a variety of different personalization features which you can use to fully customize your form to your brand or purpose. You have design options including fonts, colors and styles, desktop background image, and even how it looks on your mobile background. Besides that, you can customize how many pages you want, what type of questions you want to ask, and even insert images and videos. But that's not all there is. Because Involve Me is so flexible in design and functionality, that there are several other features that can make your form stand out way more than a Google form can. We have several playlists on YouTube where you can check out all the different personalization and customization features that Involve Me has. I will also leave some useful videos in the description below in case you want to fully dive into all the features that is offered by Involve Me. Once you are finished editing your project, go ahead and publish it and you will arrive on this screen. Here you have a few different options. You can either just copy and paste the link that is provided, or you can embed your form into your website. You have two options for embedding your Involve Me form. The first option simply allows you to embed your form as a website content. This means that Involve Me will automatically generate the best size for your form. However, if you want a different size, you can always change it by simply adding in the width and the height you would like your form to be. Then just simply click on Copy Code and head on over to your WordPress website. So I will just copy this code into the HTML text box on WordPress. And when I click on preview, it will show me how my form looks. What's great about the Involve Me embed feature is that on the website, it already shows you how it will look like if you embed it onto your website. The second option is to have your form as a full screen embed. This just means that nothing else will be on that page except for your Involve Me form. So for this one, there are no sizes as it's just going to be the whole page. So here, just do the same thing. Copy the code, and then head on over to your WordPress website. Simply copy and paste it into the HTML text box, and then click on preview. And then just simply publish your WordPress page, and you will see how amazing your Involve Me form looks on your website. As you can see, Involve Me is a much better suited tool if you're looking for more design options and a more responsive platform that is easier to embed into your website for different purposes. You can be sure that your Involve Me form will look amazing no matter what browser you are using or what technology you are viewing it from. And what's even better is that we have a discount code for you where you can get 2 months for free after you register to Involve Me. You can find the discount code in the description below. Well, that was it for today's video. I hope this video helped in understanding how to embed a Google form, as well as the benefits and limitations of the platform. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, and don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell so you're notified every time we post a new video. Thanks for watching. Bye!